Hi, Chris Chappell here in the Philippines as part of our Pivot to Asia tour. You know, everyone knows that Filipino President Duterte has been cozying up to China, but what you may not know is that the Philippines and China already have a long history together. That's why I'm standing here in Binondo, the oldest Chinatown in the world, over 400 years old. So I thought I'd show you around, but I should probably get a local to help me show me around. Oh, hey, excuse me, sir.
You're Chris Chappell.
Oh my gosh, fellow YouTuber Travis Kraft.
You look a bit lost. I'm the perfect guy. If you need any help being shown around, I can take care of that for you.
What a wonderful unstaged coincidence. Let's go. Thanks, Travis. I appreciate you taking the time to show me around the Philippines.
Absolutely. And here's the river, and it actually looks like they cleaned it up.
Wow.
Believe it or not, it was worse, but
what a wonderful smell you discovered. Yeah. Somebody.
Yes. Oh, hi.
Hi.
What a surprise seeing you here.
I've been looking for you, actually. Where did you go?
Chris, This is Imabel, my wife. Yeah, I think you've seen her on my channel.
You look so familiar.
Wow, yeah, Chris, I recognize you from the show.
Whoa.
What another coincidence.
I'm so excited. You're here.
I am. So are you going to join us and help show me around?
My pleasure.
Wonderful.
Hey. Here we are, Chris. Hopia.
So tell me a bit about this Hopia. What's special about it?
Hopia is a favorite Chinese snack.
Uh-huh.
And there are a lot of favorites here that you can choose from. I personally like Mongol.
That's Mongol.
Yes, there are different kinds of Mongol as well, but if you want to try that, then go for it.
Okay. Mongo is a type of bean.
Oh, so all right.
It's not mango, Mongo.
Oh, bean, okay. Let's see. I wonder what. Oh, what's that, Shelly? Go for the ube and cheese. Thanks, Shelly. Ube and cheese, let's get in there. I bit it on the cheese end.
What do you think?
That's pretty nice.
It's good.
It's very sweet cheese.
If it's good, if something here is delicious, you should say, Ung sarap sarap.
Ung sarap sarap.
Yeah, Ung sarap sarap.
I like that.
Galing.
How sure? Ung sarap sarap. Awesome. So, this is obviously a Catholic church.
Catholicism here is radically different than what Americans think of Catholicism.
Oh, yeah?
In America, there's a lot of emphasis on sin and living a moral lifestyle. Mm. Here, it's less of that. A lot of people here seem to have the attitude that you can kind of do what you want during the week, but as long as you tell Jesus you love him, he'll forgive you. And there's a lot of influence from the native religions before Catholicism was here. So animism has a lot of heavily influence from animism and other native things. Mm. So what you see here people doing, you'll see people going to church, lighting candles for like sculptures or pictures, touching like pictures of
saints,
of saints or the Virgin Mary, and crying and stuff. And when you see that, it's a little hard to imagine Americans doing something like that and being so dramatic.
Early Chinatown, it was filled with mostly Catholic Chinese, correct?
It was actually started by the Spanish. A Spanish leader started this for Chinese Catholics.
Mm.
And it was also kind of a way to separate things, to kind of segregate things. The Spanish could live over here, we can have the Chinese living over here, and they could have that separation. I guess they weren't into multiculturalism.
I guess not. And so apparently we came in the middle of the wet season, so it's raining now. We're gonna hop into one of these death traps and go to a nearby Taoist temple. So Alan gave me a camera, so I'm gonna be the cameraman for a little bit. Let's go. How? All right. Where? Oh gosh. Then. Oh, it's vibrating. This is quite tight and scary. Oh my gosh. This is just a motorcycle with a cage wrapped around it. So, How many people normally fit into one of these things?
Three people, and
most of them are in our size, though.
Yeah, you lift weights, don't you, Travis?
a little bit.
That's inconvenient.
Yes.
So tell me a bit more about the influence of China in the Philippines.
There's so much of a big impact in terms of the food they eat here, the holidays, and Chinese people are very superstitious. Filipinos very superstitious. Oh. So there's a lot of crossover in terms of all of that.
Okay, so the cultures really have kind of fused together. Oh my God.
We're too
heavy. Are we flipping upside
down? I know. We are.
Travis, you're too big. I think I'm going to lean forward.
It felt like the whole thing was almost flipping.
Well, welcome to the last episode of China Uncensored. I'm here with Hima and Travis. How do the Filipinos feel about the new relations Duterte is pushing with China?
We get to talk to different people, from taxi drivers to professionals, well-educated, not so educated. What some people say that they're not really okay with Duterte trying to partner with China because they don't want communism. Some people say, I think it's good, let's just trust Duterte because maybe it's his strategy to make, everything better for the Philippines.
Oh, interesting. Not letting us by. This is madness. This is madness. So I can definitely appreciate why you'd want public transit, because I would not want to drive in this.
This isn't madness. This is Manila.
This is Manila.
They took us to a different temple. There was a long, pleasant drive. Hey. A Buddhist temple, you can tell by all of the swastikas. The swastika is an ancient symbol and should not be associated with the Nazis. It's an ancient symbol that's been found in the relics of ancient Greece. I've seen it in Viking temples, Indian culture, Buddhism culture. It's a very sacred symbol. Take it back from the Nazis. So it's amazing to see all the ways China has impacted the Philippines over the hundreds of years that the presence have been here.
And continuing to impact it.
Certainly more so now.
Right. Actually, there are many temples in Binondo, but the number of Buddhists here is not really big. It's because there are many Chinese here. And there are still Chinese people who are Buddhists at the same time Christians.
They're Christian and they identify as Christian and Buddhist.
A
Buddhist nun told us here that you can be both Buddhist and Christian at the same time. They don't really conflict with each other. Since Buddhism, it's not about worshiping a god. Buddha's not God. Mm-hmm. The idea is Buddha is, and there's been many Buddhas, but the one that we call the Buddha, he's attained enlightenment, and ultimately, that's supposed to be our goal. Now, it's a very difficult thing to do, and it might take the course of several different lifetimes to do it, but that's our goal. It's like a reminder when we look at the statues of Buddha that we're supposed to attain to that perfection, as elusive as it is.
Yep. I think I've gained enlightenment. Shall we move on to the next place?
Okay, let's go.
All right, great. Now, the history of the Filipino Chinatown is pretty interesting in Manila. I know at the beginning there was a lot of tension between the Spanish and colonial government. There were issues of Chinese pirates who were unrelated to the Filipino Chinese, but that still created tensions. Then there was an uprising in the 1600s, which ended with the colonial government killing almost the entire 20,000 inhabitants of this Chinatown. I sure am thirsty after all that exhaust I inhaled.
I think that's perfect for you now. You can have some buko juice.
Wow, how perfect to have this right here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
so this is...
Mecano.
This is a coconut, right?
Okay. Yes.
A young coconut.
Less than a dollar. This is less than a dollar.
Less than
this
a dollar.
This is young coconut. That's what this is. And you drink the water, the coconut
And he
water.
Just pulled a machete out of nowhere.
It's kind of funny because we're drinking out of coconuts. You think we're in a tropical island paradise, but instead we're in this place.
All right, cheers.
Cheers.
Om salap salap. where can I buy some nice Chinese souvenirs?
This is all made in China.
Oh. So, for dinner, is there any place we can go to where they have something like Filipino food and Chinese food together, all in one plate? What an unplanned coincidence. I am so excited to try authentic Filipino Chinese food.
Well, we're here.
Oh, it's the Filipino Panda Express. Right? All right, guys, I got us some authentic Filipino Chinese buns.
Nice.
It's really amazing all the ways that Chinese culture and Filipino culture have kind of mixed together to form something totally new.
And I hope that you had a good time and learned some stuff with us as your tour guides. How were we as tour guides?
You guys were definitely the best tour guides I've ever had in the Philippines.
Very nice.
All right, let's dig in. Oh, these look interesting. It's filled with chocolate. I think we're probably done for the day. All right. Well, thank you again. Be sure to check out Travis's channel. It's called Travis Craft. He's an actor and he gives you an inside look into the Philippines. Ima's on there as well. Once again, thank you for watching this episode of China Uncensored. See you next time on our Pivot to Asia tour.